Hello everyone, I'm going to present our work, Integral Matrix Gram Root and the Lattice Gaussian Sampling Without Flow. This is a joint work with Leo Ducas, Steven Galbraith, and Thomas Prest. I am Yang Yu. This work is about the interaction between two mathematicians, Lagrange and Gauss. Our main result is a Lattice Gaussian sampler. Compared with the previous algorithm, this sampler does not use floating point arithmetic, and it achieves a similar quality but with less memory and simpler base sampling. Our techniques are some algorithms for the integral gram decomposition problem, that is, given an integral positive definite matrix sigma, find some integral matrix A such that AA transpose equals sigma. This can be viewed as an extension of Lagrange four-square theorem to matrices. Actually, Lagrange four-square theorem corresponds to the case n equals 1 and m equals 4. Okay, let's start with some background. A lattice is a discrete subgroup in Euclidean space, and it can be expressed by a basis. A lattice has infinitely many bases. We call a basis consisting of short vector, a good basis. Discrete Gaussian is an important distribution of lattices. It is specified by three parameters, the lattice L, the syntheses, and the covariance matrix sigma. For a discrete Gaussian, the probability of each lattice point is proportional to the value of the Gaussian function. In particular, when sigma is a scaled identity matrix, we call the discrete Gaussian spherical, and the parameter is the width of the spherical Gaussian. With a good basis, we can efficiently sample from some spherical Gaussian of a relatively small width, but the Gaussian itself leaks nothing about the good basis. For this reason, discrete Gaussian is widely used in lattice crypto systems, including signatures IBE, ABE. In these cases, the good basis is given by the lattice trapdoor, and the target distribution is some spherical Gaussian of a given center. The quality of the used sampler is the minimal Gaussian width it can achieve. Actually, a smaller Gaussian width implies a higher security level, then higher quality of the sampler. Currently, there are two main approaches to do lattice Gaussian sampling. The first one is the KGPV sampler. It was proposed by Klein and then first used for lattice cryptography by the famous GPV paper. This sampler can be viewed as a randomized version of Babai nearest plane algorithm. And the second approach was proposed by Packard. And the Packard sampler can be viewed as a randomized version of Babai rounding off algorithm. Compared with the KGPV sampler, Packard's algorithm has some quality loss, but it is more efficient. In addition, Packard's sampler turns out convenient in lattice trapdoor setting. In this work, we focus on Packard's sampler. Let's recall its details. The high-level idea of Packard's algorithm is Gaussian convolution. Note that, with the sampling basis B, it is easy to sample from some discrete Gaussian of covariance B B transpose. Actually, this can be done by first doing some integer Gaussian sampling, and then performing a transformation of B. This Gaussian is non-spherical. To rectify it to a spherical Gaussian, Packard proposed to add some perturbation vector of a certain covariance sigma t. And he showed that the sum of these two non-spherical Gaussians can be a spherical one, just like the case of continuous Gaussian. And the sampling of perturbation vector is independent of the input center, so it can be performed in in the offline phase. In the online phase, we only need to deal with one-dimensional Gaussian sampling, and that is relatively easy. Indeed, the online sampling can be fully performed over integers. However, the offline sampling still heavily relies on floating-point arithmetic. That is because, on the one hand, it requires to do some continuous Gaussian sampling, and on the other, it requires some gram root A of sigma p. And the only suggested way to compute such A is a Cholesky decomposition, so that A is a square matrix but of high precision. There are many drawbacks of floating point arithmetic. For example, it requires to do some tedious numerical stability analysis, and high precision would lead to extra storage and lower efficiency. Moreover, floating point arithmetic suffers from weak determinism. That is, even with the same input and the same randomness, the result can be different on different machines. This may be dangerous for some applications like signatures and IBE. So, we want to get rid of floating point arithmetic in the whole Lattice Gaussian sampling. This is the motivation of our work. Our main idea is to use a rectangle but integral gram root to replace the previous square but real Cholesky root. To this end, we formally studied the problem, integral gram decomposition problem, IGDP. And the IGDP problem is specified by four parameters, where n is the dimension of the matrix sigma, and b is an upper bound of the spectral norm of sigma. Both n and b are determined by the Lattice crypto system itself. And d is proportional to the final Gaussian width, so it is mainly determines the quality of final Gaussian sampler. And m equals the number of required integer sampling. In our sampler, the integer sampling are centered. Our goal is to solve the IGDP problem with fixed n and b, while keeping d is only slightly larger than b, and the m relatively small. We note that for the case n equals 1, IGDP problem can be solved by Lagrange 4 square theorem with m equals 4. And for general case, our idea is to reduce the IGDP instance of a large dimension to the one of a smaller dimension. And this can be expressed as this reduction. To build such a reduction, we make use of gauge decomposition. Actually, by a gauge decomposition, we can express a vector consisting of large coefficients as the product of a small matrix and the gauge vector G. So, we can first computing a gram matrix according to the sigma. And then, adding this gram matrix on sigma, we can clean out the elements in the first row and the corner. And this remaining diagonal element can be dealt with by the four square decomposition. And this lower right block actually corresponds to an IGDP instance of dimension n minus 1. So we get this reduction. Repeating this reduction, we can finally compute an integral gram root A of matrix Di minus sigma. And the resulting matrix A has a regular structure like this. Indeed, the core number of A can be much larger than n. But an interesting fact here is that such a rectangle matrix A can be inf- efficiently stored, and the overall storage is independent of the core number. That is because for a large parameter k, the gauge base b would be small. So the off-diagonal element here are small. So far, we have solved some IGDP instance, but the initial decomposition only applies to some large parameter d. This implies a significant overhead on the final Gaussian width. To overcome this issue, we also consider another reduction called eigenvalue reduction. This reduction allows us to reduce the IGDP instance for large matrix to the one for small matrix. And to build it, our idea is simple. We pre-compute some approximate square root of matrix EI minus sigma. Then, to decompose the matrix DI minus sigma, we only need to decompose the matrix D minus B times I minus sigma prime. And the spectral norm of sigma prime is much less than the spectral norm of sigma. Note that the overhead is only related to the small matrix sigma prime, so it can be negligible compared with the original parameter B. And this leads to a negligible overhead on the final Gaussian width. Combining the eigenvalue reduction and the initial decomposition, we get our final decomposition. In some advanced applications like HIBE, ABE, the spectral norm of matrix can be very large. And in such a setting, the final decomposition could be like this. We first perform the eigenvalue reduction once, and then we apply the initial decomposition with k equals 3. The resulting integral gram root will have a core number 9n, and this method applies to some d is only slightly larger than d. With such an integral gram root, we can adapt the packed sampler to an integer version. This is the comparison between our sampler and the packed one. We can see our algorithm achieves asymptotically better storage. That is because in packed sampler, it requires to store a Chorlitsky root, and the coefficient in this matrix require a precision about lambda bit. Here, lambda is the security parameter that is often set as big O n. Also, the base sampling in our algorithm are easy to implement, and no flows are used in our algorithm. The quality of final Gauss remains almost the same as the one in practice approach. So we have seen the sampling algorithms for generic integer matrix. For better performance, actually, many Lattice crypto systems are built in the ring setting. The previous algorithms can indeed apply to the ring setting by simply viewing the ring element as its matrix form. However, the decomposition algorithm would break the underlying ring structure so that it loses the efficiency improvement of the ring. To maintain the ring advantage in the ring setting, or to maintain the efficiency advantage in the ring setting, we want the integral gram root to preserve the underlying structure. Driven by this, we formally studied the problem, IGDP problem over ring. Here we introduced the underlying ring as a new parameter. In this work, we focus on the case of power of intercyclotomic ring. Okay. To solve the generalized IGBP problem over the ring, we follow a similar idea of projecting the problem into smaller dimensions. But this time, we require to decompose some polynomial in the ring setting. To do so, we need to do a reduction on the underlying ring. And by this reduction chain, we can write a polynomial d minus a as the sum of a serial polynomial ai star. Here, the star denotes the complex conjugation, and note that the matrix form of A star is actually the transpose of the matrix form of A. And here D is an integer. So this can be viewed as an analog of four square decomposition for power of two cyclotomic ring. To build such a reduction on the underlying ring, we develop a new tool called ring gauge. Let's recall some simple facts. First, a polynomial f can be expressed by two sub-ring elements fe and fo, where fe corresponds to the even part and fo corresponds to the odd part of f. Second, when the polynomial f is self-adjoint, that is, f equals f star, then its odd part actually is the sum of some polynomial and its complex conjugation. To project the problem onto a subring, we only need to clean out the odd part of some polynomial. And this can be done by simply adding some polynomial AA star on F. And we note that this projection is also compatible with the gauge decomposition. Instead of adding one polynomial AA star, we can first computing a serial AI according to gauge decomposition, and then adding the sum of AI AI star. So we call the combination of gauge decomposition and projection as a ring gauge. And by the ring gauge, we can build the reduction on the underlying ring. Okay, with an integral Graham root over ring, we can adapt the previous algorithm as a ring-based Gaussian sampler. Compared with the previous generic solution, the ring-based sampler achieves a quasi-linear improvement in both storage and running time. But the cost is that it requires more base sampling, because the resulting Graham Graham root in the ring setting has an even larger core number than the generic solution. Okay, to conclude, in this work, we formally studied the IGDP problem, integral Graham decomposition problem. This can be viewed as an extension of Lagrange four-square theorem to matrices. As an application, we propose a Lattice Gaussian sampler. It does not rely on floating-point arithmetic, and it can be fully performed over integers. That is my talk. Thank you.